We're here at the campus of the University of Virginia College at Wise for Press Day 2013 as the Cavaliers get set to enter the 2013 football season, a new era for the Cavalier football team. They are entering the NCAA Division II, second year of qualifications, and they're also in a new conference. And so it will be a new season here on the campus of the University of Virginia College at Wise as the Cavaliers and head coach Lusk get set for the new adventure in the NCAA Division II. As we get set for press day here, and we will be talking with various players as we go on today, and we will be back here just in a minute.
Well, my name's Dewey Lusk, the head football coach at UVA Wise, and we're looking forward to this new opportunity and challenge going NCAA Division II in the Mountain East Conference. Our kids are very excited. The whole school college community is very excited. So we've got a big challenge in front of us, and we're looking forward to it.
What talk about the process that you all went through to get to be a Division II?
Well, we're in our second year, starting our second year going into this thing. We had to hire a compliance person right off the bat. We had one AD and an assistant AD. Now we've got an assistant AD for academics, one for compliance. We've had to learn a lot of rules and regulations and adhere to those rules and regulations. So there's been a lot of learning going on. Took our first recruiting test there a couple months ago. But it's just different, it's new, we're getting used to all the new things going on, and we're looking forward to this challenge.
You mentioned it being new. Talk about some of the, you mentioned briefly the excitement, but elaborate a little bit more on the excitement that it's bringing.
Well, I'll give you an example. We had our media day there a couple weeks ago, and walked in, and the place was full of media and news people and folks interested in the Mountain East Conference and in NCAA Division II. And, we just didn't have that with the NAIA like you do in this league. And everybody in the community, they can't wait for football to start, and they're excited about it. There's questions and trying to figure this thing out. But the newness has definitely excited everybody.
With the newness and it being – talk about some of the strengths that you already see with this team that you have coming in.
Well, you could see a big difference in recruiting. Talking about NCAA Division II and seeing the blue ball, it gets folks interested, and parents' eyes perk up, and the kids you're recruiting, they're wanting to listen more, and you can already see a difference in this recruiting class that came in this year, and I think you're going to see a big difference in years to come. I really do.
You're entering your third year here at UVA Wise. You've got one starting running back coming back, and you got your starting quarterback coming back and a big defensive back coming back. So how's the team gelling as you start practice this fall?
Well, they're gelling really well. You know, we were 3-8 last year, and the one of the many things that the kids learned from last year is we have to be a team, and can't have any selfish players. They understand. They want to be disciplined. And, you know, you talk about those kids coming back, but we've got 9 returning starters on offense, 6 on defense. Now we've got some things to learn about these new teams we're playing because we haven't played any of those schools. But there's an excitement amongst the kids, and, I mean, they're hustling around. They're playing hard. They're giving it all they have. And we're real anxious for the first game to get here.
Well, you mentioned media day. You were picked 9th in this new conference, and Shepherd is picked to win it. What do you know about Shepherd compared to UVA Wise?
Well, I do know this. I run the offense here at UVA Wise, along with being the head coach. And when you hear the stat, Shepherd gave up 546 yards rushing the entire season last year, and they were the number one ranked defensive team versus the rush last year in the country. That got my attention. They've got tremendous athletes. I think they have 8 starters back on defense, 8 on offense. And we'll have our hands full when that day comes. But right now, we're getting ready for Campbell University opening day, and see where that takes us.
Well, you say you're getting ready for Campbell on opening day. You played them last year, so you're familiar with them, but you got to go back to their place this year.
We're familiar with where we're playing. We're familiar with how to get there, but they have a new head coach as well. Mike Mentor got hired last spring, and he's their new head coach. They do open up August 31st, the week before we play, so maybe we'll have an opportunity to be able to see what they're doing. But at this point, there's no film or anything, so all we can go by is what our coaching friends tell us that Coach Mentor has run in the past and that kind of thing. But hopefully we'll know a little something on them after that August 31st date.
You mentioned that you had nine returners on offense. Talk about some other specific strengths or positives that you see on the offensive side of the ball.
We've got the freshman of the year, Mid-South Conference, coming back, and Terrence Younger at wide receiver, a tremendous athlete. He played at William Campbell in Naruna up near Lynchburg. Tremendous athlete. We're looking for big things out of him. Also return another starter at wide out in Julian Stewart. Julian's from East Montgomery in Shawlsville. Tall, rangy, smart kid. Of course, Cullen Lavoie, as you mentioned earlier, is coming back at quarterback. Zach Cochran's returning at tailback. But we also have returning Sean Atkins, who will be a senior. He got hurt in the first game last year against Bethel and had to redshirt the entire year last year. Andre Dickerson's a senior running back that's got playing time over the years that'll be back with us. Jamal Williams at tight end. And we've got Kevin Enix coming back off a broken leg injury before the first game last year, and he had played some his freshman year, so he has some experience as well. Mike Barber's coming back for his senior year. We've moved him down to guard, but four of the five starters on the offensive line are back as well. I had a coach one time told me he was probably 70 years old, and he stood up in front of the whole team and said, if just being a year older makes you a better player, then I'd be the best player in here. So they've worked hard, and we'll see. Hopefully the hard work will pay off that first ball game.
Now flip to the other side of the ball. Talk a little specifics about your defense.
Defensively, we're returning six starters. We're also returning some kids that got to play a bunch. Marcus Jones, we had him at free safety last year. We've moved him up to an outside linebacker position. We've got Nehemiah Jones back. He's played corner. He's played all over the map. He's played outside backer. He's played cornerback. Vernon Payne from Western Branch, he'll be a senior, and he's a cornerback, tremendous athlete. Jeremiah Cook from right here in Wise is back and doing a tremendous job, has a big-time motor. E.J. Holland's back. He'll be a sophomore. I've also got Walter Mickey back for his senior year, defensive tackle, tremendously quick young man. Matt Sandoval at linebacker, he came in last year from Fork Union Military Academy and a very disciplined, hard-nosed young person. Tontre Billups is back, another inside linebacker who played at Oscar Smith, a good high school program up at Chesapeake. So we've got several returning starters on both sides of the ball, and also in our kicking game in Paul Melshin, who broke the school record for field goals last year. Tyler Graham returns. He's also a kicker and will take over the punting duties for Dean Hogan, who graduated last year, so we feel really good about our kicking game. Our whole deal is, how are we going to respond to this move to NCAA Division II, and when we have some adverse things happen to us, how are we as a team going to handle the adversity? And, we were very young last year, started several freshmen. Those kids are now sophomores. Sprinkle in a few juniors and 15 seniors with another good freshman recruiting class. We're kind of anxious to get going and see what we can do.
With all this newness, and we mentioned in the media day you all projected ninth, but preseason projections mean nothing.
It's where you finish.
But what are some of your all's expectations and goals that you all set for this season?
Well, obviously you want to win a conference championship, and that would be nice to do. But we're working on being a disciplined team, being unselfish, trying to cut back on our turnovers offensively. We've got to get better at stopping the run on defense, and we have to get better at running the football offensively. If we can have a sound kicking game and get better in those facets of the game, we'll have an opportunity – to give ourselves a chance to win in the fourth quarter in some of these games. And that's all you can ask for.
Okay, you mentioned Jeremiah Cook is coming back. A couple of other local guys. You got the Mead boy from
Trey Mead from Clintwood.
And Cody Kraft from
Cody Kraft from Union. And if I don't mention Gil Lusk from Powell Valley High School, Mom was going to get me.
Yes, she will. And those are three or four local players that people should come out and watch this.
Oh, game. Absolutely. And we need all the support we can get. We want this UVA Wise to be Southwest Virginia's team. And come out and support us. I tell you what, they're going to be a fun bunch to watch.
You had a very successful season last year. Are you looking forward to another successful season this year?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to another successful season. We got a whole lot of key returners on offense and a whole lot of key returners on defense. And we all gel together. I think we have a great season.
You're coming out of the NAIA and going into NCAA Division II, a new conference, new teams. Do you think that'll give you any problems this season, or do you think you can step up and become an NCAA Division II team?
I think it's going to be – the competition will probably be about the same. As long as we gel together and, like, join together and make big plays, I think we'll be fine in the Mountain East Conference.
What are you excited about for this season?
I'm excited about moving up to D2 football, playing against about the same competition, and I'm just real excited for the season this year.
You're returning back front on the offense. What are some strengths that you see so far on this offensive side of the ball?
We got a quarterback back, a running back. Our receiving core is pretty strong. I think we'll be a real good season.
Talk about your all schedule, since it's a new schedule. What do you think about it?
Our schedule is going to be pretty tough. We start off with Campbell, September 7th. And then we get into Division II Mountain East Conference, September 14th. I think we'll have a good year, a whole lot of good competition.
With all the newness, the new conference, new division, what are some of y'all's expectations for this season?
They picked us to finish 9th in the conference. So we're going to have to just go out and make a statement first game and show them that we should be way further than last in the conference.
Okay, you're the returning quarterback from last year. You started as a freshman. How do you feel coming in as a sophomore?
I feel real good coming in as a sophomore, just a whole lot more comfortable with the system. And we worked real hard over the offseason, so I feel really good about this season and ready to get it underway.
As a quarterback and just as a sophomore, quarterback's leader of the team, as an underclassman still, how do you lead this team?
I just have to play a big role and try to lead by example and just lead verbally when I can. But just get after it out here in practice and just work hard every day and getting better.
Talk about all the newness with this season, Division II, new conference. Talk about that.
Oh, yeah. We're going to the NCAA Division II, so it's gonna be challenging, but it's nothing that we can't handle. We're just going to take it a game at a time and just play and hope for the best.
You all are projected 9th in the preseason poll, but it means nothing.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
But to get to that point, to prove people wrong, what are some aspects on the offense that you see as positives?
We have a lot of good returning wide receivers, as you spoke with Terrence, and it's a really good defense this year. And we just got to do our best to win, put points up, and just play a whole lot more smarter this year.
You're from East Tennessee State. How did you come to choose UVA Wise as your college?
I went to Sevier County High School, and just Coach Luss had a few offers and then just came up here on a visit, and I really liked it, really liked the coaching staff and the people around here. So, and I could just see myself on this field, so that's why I chose UVA Wise.
Thank you.
You're one of the defensive quarterbacks. How is the defense looking as far as the early practice has gone?
I mean, defense is looking real, real clean. Coach Ham has us right this season. I have a lot of confidence going into this season. And for a lot of upcoming freshmen are really showing out. So I'm excited. I'm excited about the defense this year.
We already spoke to a couple different people on the offensive side. What particular strengths do you see on the defensive side of the ball?
We really had a focus coming into this season about our run defense. So our linebackers is really stepping up, stopping the run, in every practice. So we're looking way stronger for our run defense.
With all the newness, that's D2, that's new conference, what are some of your old goals and expectations for this season?
Our goals are to win a conference, without a doubt. We're not ducking from anybody. I feel real confident about our offense, our defense, our special teams, and with our new strength and conditioning coach Bernie has us right. So we have us. I'm real confident about this season going into D2.
Do you have anything else? Thank you.
You're a sophomore. You're coming back from last season as a freshman, and you're starting as a cornerback defense. How's the defense projected for this new season and a new conference?
Our defense has improved from last year. We were young last year, and we got more techniques, and our defense is just more dominant than last year.
Talk about the excitement surrounding this upcoming season.
Our team's really hyped, ready to get at it. We really think we can, with the competition we got, we can handle it and it'll be a new thing to get at. So,
What would make this year successful for you all?
I feel like if we won the conference and just showing everybody that we're the team to look at, we'd get everybody's eyes on us.
What motivates this team?
Last year, we didn't do as well, so we just want to show everybody around that nothing to play with. So.
What is it like coming into your senior year with all the newness that you all have going on right now?
It's good. All the new freshmen are really good. This is probably the best class I've seen. I've been at numerous schools, but this freshman class is the best one I've seen. So.
Talk about being a senior, but having a sophomore quarterback being the leader of the team.
It's good. He got a lot of he was thrown in the fire last year, but he really stepped up, so we rely on him and we trust him.
What have been some of the focus points of improvement from last season into this year?
Leadership and building the team, make us one, put us together, and make sure we bond. It was a big deal this year.
What's it like for you as a senior getting 1 year but being in the Division II playing in the new conference?
Oh, it's going to be good. I mean, it's going to be a step up from NAIA. It'll be exciting to see what we can do.
Talk about coming into your senior year. What are you expecting out of this season?
Well, I'm just expecting everybody to give their all. If they give me their all, then I feel like we can do it.
What, as a senior, being just 1 year, but you're still getting to have that taste of D2, being mm-hmm. from NAIA, it's probably something you didn't expect to happen while you've been here. What is that like for you?
I mean, I feel like it's an opportunity. This is our shot. We got to make it happen this year. This is the only year I got, so I got to make it happen.
Senior cornerback on the defense, talk mm-hmm. about some of the strengths that you see on the defensive side of the ball.
We some hitters, the physicality. We turned it up from last year. We was kind of soft, But Coach Ham, he drilled it into our head. We got to get physical. It's D2. They some heavy hitters.
What are some specific expectations that you all have?
I mean, no expectations. As long as we work hard, that dedication, hard work pay off. I learned that a long time ago.
You're a returning senior. As you said, you had a very successful campaign as a junior. What do you plan as a senior to add to that success?
Work ethic. I mean, I can't add nothing that I can't bring to it unless I work for it, Nothing come easy in the world. Everybody know that.
Thank you.
No problem.
Good luck.
Thank you.
State your name and spell it for us.
Christian D. Jarnett, CHRISTIAN, JARNETTE.
Number, position, and year?
25, linebacker, senior.
Senior leader on the defense. Linebackers like the quarterback on the defensive side of the ball. What are some of the things that you were doing to step up as a leader on the defense?
Well, as a leader, my part is to add the discipline.
What have you all seen that you need to improve on or have improved on from last season coming into this year?
Well, the physicality, like Vernon Payne said, we have very improved on that. So we're looking forward to landing some big hits this year.
Talk about moving into Division II and the excitement with the new conference.
It's a challenge. It's a challenge, and we all, as a team, as a whole, we accept that challenge. So we're looking forward to it to do great. We've been working hard, so we're really, really ready to get this thing started.
What are some of your all's expectations that you have for this year?
The expectation is, number one, stop the run on defense. On offense, to score more points.
Let's say you're a senior coming back. You've been here for 4 years, and you're getting ready to go into Division II, as everyone knows around here, and step up the pace. Do you think that this team is ready to move on to that next level?
Yes, sir. We have accepted the challenge, and we've been working hard every day since last season.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.
You're a former LPD player from Powell Valley / Union, and you've been here, and you're also the coach's son. How difficult has that been?
It's kind of difficult, but, I mean, he likes to make an example out of me, and I got to be a good role model for everybody else. So, I mean, I like it, you know. I like getting to go home and talk football with the old man.
Oh, go ahead.
Well, like, say you're a wide receiver, slot receiver. You got a sophomore quarterback coming back that played a lot last year. Has the offense improved?
I think the offense has improved a lot. I think our passing game's improved a lot. You can tell that Colin Lavoie's matured a lot in the offseason. He knows offense a lot better, and he's been making really good reads so far in summer camp.
Well, all the talk in the offseason has been about the new conference and going to NCAA Division II, and I'm sure that there's been a lot of discussion in team meetings and coaching meetings about that.
Yeah, we're real excited about it, see what new challenges come about in this conference. So we're real excited to go play these new teams, you know.
You're a local boy. What's it like to play in the community or the area that you've grown up in?
I love playing for UVA Wise and representing the home team, you know, playing for my area, playing for the Mountains. I've been going to the game since I was in eighth grade, so it's just like I'm playing for my favorite team out here.
Awesome.
Thank you and good luck.
Thank you.
Well, Trey, you're from Clintwood. You've been here for 3 years, going into your third year. And again, how does it feel to be playing locally at collegiate level?
It's very nice to have people that you know and seen every day of your life to show up to your games and support you. I also enjoy representing, you know, our local area in a college atmosphere like this.
You come from a very successful program at Clintwood High School, and comparing high school to college, I know there's not much comparison, but give us some idea of what happens.
Well, the talent level increases a lot. You come from a small pool, you're the big fish in high school. You come here, everybody's the best from their school, you know. Competition level is a lot different. As for the program, there's not a whole lot of difference. They both preach about discipline, which I enjoy that, and it's a different world.
Coming into your junior season, you have a sophomore quarterback. What are some strengths that you see on the offensive side of the ball so far?
Well, right now our passing game has improved tremendously over the offseason. Like Gillard said, Colin Lavoie has matured a lot, and he's making the right reads and getting the ball out on time, so I feel like we'll have a pretty explosive offense this year.
Local boy coming in for your freshman year, and you're moving into D2. What's this like?
I mean, it's different. I mean, everybody here, they're the big dog at their school, and everybody knows that you got to work hard and stuff. So it's different.
How does it feel? Do you feel like you have an advantage coming in as a freshman with everything that's new? You're gonna have 4 years of being in it rather than some of the other seniors, juniors.
I mean, no, I don't feel like that, but you still got to work hard and stuff, so it'll be a challenge, but I'm going to try.
What's it like playing for a team that you've grown up around or been around in the community?
I mean, it's great. You know, you still see people that you know from the community and stuff around here at the games, and it's just good seeing people that you know coming to support you and stuff.
Cody, you come from Union High School. You played for Coach Turner down there. How much did he prepare you for this next level of football?
He prepared me very well. I mean, we all taught discipline. Discipline was preached, you know, keeping your head right. He preached that up here. It's the same thing. So he did a very good job.
Thank you.
Again, we're here at the campus of the University of Virginia College at Wise for Press Day 2013 for the football season. We're coming to a close. We've talked to some various players both across the state of Virginia and local players that hope to make an impact here at the University of Virginia College at Wise. As we say so long for Press Day from the campus of the University of Virginia College at Wise, this is Herb Short along with cameraman T-Bone, and we'll see you when the season starts in September.